Hey, it's Jeffrey Pepper Rogers back with Guitar Sessions. And the song for today is The Beatles Across the Universe, which has been on my mind, like lots of other people, because of the Get Back documentary and that incredible view of the Beatles at work making the Let It Be album. Really interesting song. John Lennon felt it was one of his best songs. It's got a lot of really cool irregularities in the phrasing of the melody, in the chord progression, in the meter. And so I'm going to teach you an arrangement that's based on how it's played on Let It Be, but also includes some elements that I've added thanks to using drop D tuning on this arrangement, which John Lennon did not use, but it works great on this song, and it makes possible some riffs that are just not available in standard tuning. So let's dive in. And as with all the episodes of Guitar Sessions, you can find charts, downloadable charts for everything you hear in this lesson over on Patreon. So if you go to Learn Across the Universe, there's one immediate twist, which is that on the album, the key that the song sounds in is C sharp. And John Lennon's actually using D shapes on a guitar tuned down a half step. So there's lots of songs that use a setup like that, tuned down a half step or a whole step. Tends to really throw people off. Yesterday, the Beatles' Yesterday is a really famous example of that. Sounds in the key of F, but actually played with G shapes on a guitar tuned down a step. You can check out the previous episode of Guitar Sessions for a lesson about John Fogerty and songs like Fortunate Son and other Creedence Clearwater hits that use that lowered tuning down a step. So you got two options, at least two options, for playing this song in the original key. One is, of course, just to tune your guitar down a half step to E flat and play using D shapes. Another would be to use C shapes and put a capo at the first fret. But for simplicity's sake here, so you don't have to retune, I'm just going to play it in the key of D. Over on Patreon, along with the charts, you can find a track that is pitch adjusted to the key of D, so you can play along with it without retuning your guitar. So this song has eight chords, and they are D, F sharp minor, A, B minor, E minor 7, A7, G minor, and G major. So G minor is really the wild card chord in there. It's the one non-diatonic chord that doesn't occur naturally in the key of D major. So it really jumps out. But let's look at the shapes that you would use using drop D tuning. So first we just have a couple ways to play D, a regular D major shape, but with drop D tuning we can include the bottom strings on that. And then another nice voicing of D can take advantage of this, which again, thanks to drop D tuning, is this one, where I'm fretting the fourth string, fourth fret. I'm actually leaving the first string out of this one. Now for F sharp minor, there's one way to play it. I could leave the top two strings open which actually gives me an F sharp minor 11, or if I were just to leave the first string out but leave the second string open in there, that would be an F sharp minor add 11. Then we've got A7. Or an alternate A7, putting the seventh up on top. Or this A7 includes the seventh twice. It's on the open third string, and it's on the first string. Now for B minor, got our standard B minor bar chord. If you leave that first string open. Got a B minor, add 11. Now for E minor 7. There's one way to do it. Got a bar on the bottom three strings, and then I'm adding 3rd fret 2nd string. Also E minor 7. Now I'm leaving the top four strings open on this one. Or that's an E minor 7 that again has a 7th in it twice. It's on the open 4th string and also on the 2nd string. For G minor, could use that shape, which is the same as what I showed for F sharp minor, but just moved up a fret. Or a few other ways, variations on that. One would be leaving the 4th string open, fretting the 5th string, or simplifying that a little bit, now muting the 5th string, G major. Fretting the bottom two strings at the 5th fret, or I could leave that 5th string out and just mute it. Play it like this. Now if I fret the top two strings at the 3rd fret and still leave that 5th string muted, that's a G5, so that's a voicing that does not have the 3rd in it. Or I could even simplify it a little bit more, a voicing I use a lot, which is a G5 just on the 6th, 4th, 3rd, and 2nd strings. So as I mentioned, there's some really interesting variations, irregularities in this song. So the chord progression changes. So first verse ends with a E minor 7 to G minor. But in the third verse, that E minor 7 to G minor pops up in the second line of the verse rather than the last line. The whole progression throughout just feels like it's constantly unfolding rather than repeating exactly, which I'm sure was very intentional on John Lennon's part. So also, if you pick apart the meter, you'll notice a bunch of things that are kind of tricky to track at first. So there's a few instances where there are measures of 2/4, so there are half measures of two beats that pop up on E minor 7. There also are some measures on the words "across the universe" where he adds a beat, so it's really a measure of 5/4 instead of 4. Doesn't do it every time, but sometimes. But in the full version of the song and in the charts on Patreon, you'll hear it as it was on the Let It Be album in terms of where these little irregularities pop up. So I'm going to play through now the progression for the first verse and chorus without singing. At the end of this lesson, we'll do a full run through of the song with vocals. I'm playing this with a flat pick. Lennon strummed this song. Finger style is also really nice, and I actually do some hybrid picking as well, which we'll get into in the full version of this when I go over some of the riffs. So hybrid picking meaning picking the low strings with the pick and grabbing treble strings with my middle finger. Here we go. 1, 2. 1, 2, 3, 4. Thank you. right, so now let's look at some of the riffs, starting off with that beautiful little intro that Lennon played. So this is going to be a series of double stops played in the first part of it, played on the first and third strings together, while letting the fourth string ring. So starts off second fret, and then all the way up here at the 10th and 11th fret, and then 9th, 7th, 5 and 6, and then that's the 7th fret on the 2nd string. So play that a couple times. Then we're going to go to an F sharp minor shape just on the 4th, 3rd, and 2nd strings. I'm hammering on with my pinky on the 3rd string, 4th fret. You could always pick that note if it's hard to make it sound as a hammer-on. 4 times doing that. And then a very similar figure, but on an A, so now adding in the open 5th string. Again, it's that same hammer-on, 2nd fret to 4th fret on the 3rd string. So here's the F sharp minor again. So let me just do that whole intro. I just want to show you a few embellishments. The first one is on the word alm. So this is taken from the arrangement. I believe it's string parts that play this melody. So it starts off in the chorus. Over an A shape. Hammering on the 3rd string. Hammering again on the 2nd string onto the 3rd fret. And it will wind up on that open 1st string. On that A7. So I can kind of play the melody along with my voice on that. Nothing's gonna change my world. So a little extra embellishment there. Just over the A7, I'm just hammering on the 2nd string. So that's just kind of a nice thing to do in between the vocals. And as you'll hear in the full version, I will syncopate that sometimes. But it's the same hammer on here, going up to the 3rd fret on the 2nd string. And then nothing's gonna, and here again I can play the melody along with the voice. Nothing's gonna change my world. So So that's just a way to enhance the melody a little bit. Nothing's gonna change my world. 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 And finally, over the outro, it sounds really nice to play that outro vocal melody on the guitar. So, Jai Guru Deva. So you can on top of a sort of a D drone, that melody is right here. Starting on the third string, second fret. Jai Guru Deva. Jai Guru Deva. So with a few other open strings added on, you sound like... use something like that to close the song. All right, so there are all the parts of this arrangement of Across the Universe. I'm going to do a full version here, singing with Wendy Ramsey. Nice song to sing all in harmony. So again, you can find all the charts for everything I've done here, tab and the details over on Patreon. And I hope you have fun with this song, and thanks for watching. And now here is the full Across the Universe.
Words are flowing out like endless rain into a paper cup. They slither wildly as they slip away across the universe. Pools of sorrow, waves of joy are drifting through my open mind, possessing and caressing me. Jai Guru Deva. Nothing's gonna change my light which dance before me like a million eyes. They call me on and on across the universe. Thoughts meander like a restless wind inside a letterbox. They tumble blindly as they make their way across the universe. Nothing's gonna change my world. limitless, undying love, which shines around me like a million suns. It calls me on and on across the universe. Nothing's gonna change my world. Nothing's gonna change.